I think a few things really, sort of stuck out as, real deep learnings to take forward from this. One was the, incredible amounts of collaboration across, our employees, across our value chains, across our, with our partners, between our partners, with government, with other funders. I think the level of communication that we were all in with one another was extremely productive because, I mean, everybody was trying to respond, both in the first wave and the second wave to a crisis situation, and that enabled us to really sort of learn from one another very quickly. And I think what was really unique about this collaboration is how quickly it yielded results. Even for things that we were trying very hard to do for a long while. For example, we work on worker entitlements in construction. It's something we've been doing for a few years, but the speed at which we were able to unlock emergency cash relief from government, because everybody was fundamentally in this together and sort of learning from one another, and no one had all the answers. I think it's been for specifically for the not-for-profit we work with, and our whole portfolio and ourselves as a CSR practice. I think what has been what has been really impact what has been a big impact in the past 18 months is taking a long, hard look at our programs and saying that, COVID has obviously disrupted it. There are many needs that we didn't know existed, even though those needs were there before COVID. It's just that it's been brought to light. Whether that's in accessing government schemes, whether that's in accessing finance to scale micro enterprises. And so between the first and the second wave, we had this really nice sort of reflective period to be able to think, okay, what have we learned from this first wave that can be baked into programming moving forward?